So right now, there are over 40,000 National Guard members across the country helping states in the fight against the coronavirus, 3,000 of them right here in New York. But now the Trump administration has reportedly ordered a, quote, hard stop on their deployments for June 24th, which is just one day short of the needed time to allow many Guardsmen and women to become eligible for certain federal benefits. One of those National Guards members who was deployed to help set up a COVID-19 hospital in Staten Island last month was their congressman, Democrat Max Rose, and he joins us now via Zoom. Congressman, thanks for being here.
Hey, thanks so much for having me.
So you've called this move by the administration heartless. Explain what they're doing and why you think this is heartless.
Sure, certainly. Before I get into that, I got to say to Mr. Foy, 230 lights for $1 million. I'm fearful he's getting ripped off. We should have gone into the light business. That seems like a crazy amount. But we'll discuss that.
We'll have to put that to the MTA chairman, yeah.
We'll discuss that on another day. Look, I had the great privilege of putting the uniform back on and serving with my brothers and sisters in the 69th Infantry Unit, New York City's Infantry Battalion, as we stood up a COVID-only facility on Staten Island. And I got to tell you, these National Guard soldiers, not just here in New York, but throughout the country, have made extraordinary sacrifices. They're spending significant time away from home. They're putting their lives on the line each and every day, potentially getting COVID, but nonetheless doing the right thing by the country. And here, the White House makes the decision to cut them off at 89 days. Now you say, why 89 days? Why would you do that then? Well, at 90 days, they get access to 40% free public tuition at a public college, as well as 3 months earlier retirement. So there's significant costs to going to the 90th day, and the White House is choosing to make a budgetary decision on the backs of our soldiers who just risked their lives for us. It is not patriotic, it is unconscionable, it is heartless, it is cold, and it's got to change.
So what is the recourse? Is there anything that can be done if you raise this with the White House?
Absolutely, there's something that can be done, and it's very simple. The White House changes their mind. The White House changes their decision and shifts from 89 days to 91 days. You know, we are soldiers, right? When they sign up for the National Guard, they do so understanding that there are certain benefits in line. You do 90 days of active duty, you get access to certain aspects of the GI Bill. You do 90 days active duty, you get those 3 months saved off of when you get your retirement. Why even tell them that if we're going to rip them off at the 89th day? Let's just make it 5,000 days. We can stop lying to them, because right now we care more about shaving costs than we do about serving our soldiers. This at a time when it's very clear that we have the money. How do I know we have the money? Because we're giving millions upon millions, billions to businesses, rightfully so. But we also got to be there for our soldiers.
Yeah, when they were there for us. Aside from deploying in the Guard, Congressman, and being a sitting congressman, you're also a new dad. You and your wife, Lee, adopted a new baby. Congrats on that. How has life as a new dad and navigating this pandemic been for you?
I'm first of all, blessed to have the most wonderful, creative, beautiful, loving wife in the world, and we're just so overjoyed that our family just got a little bit bigger. I was on night duty last night, 1 a.m., 5 a.m., changing diapers. You know, at 1 a.m., I went with the disposable diaper because these reusable diapers are incredibly complicated, and I can't figure them out in the middle of the night.
That's a pro tip right there, pro dad.
But that's, you know, you got to keep the reusable and the disposable both accessible, because it's a little bit above my pay grade. But I'm learning, my friend. I'm learning.
All right. Well, congratulations to you. Good luck with the diapers, and we appreciate you raising this about the Guard as well. Thanks so much, Max Rose, Congressman.
Hey, God bless. Thanks so much, my friend.
Thank you.